Hey guys, in the previous session of GST, we have learned how GST accounting is done by categorizing it into input GST and output GST. We had also solved problems based on that. And let's not forget the exercise part. We are sure that you all must have solved it. Before discussing the solution, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon to get the notifications of new videos uploaded. So let's discuss the solution for previous video's exercise. There were two questions given where you were asked to calculate GST amount, find out the total amount receivable or payable, and pass the journal entries. Also, the tax rate given was 18%. So the first question was, Raj is a dealer in Rajasthan, purchased a table worth 15,000 from a GST registered dealer within his state on 19th Feb 2019. So let's see the solution. The first thing that you always need to check is that whether the transaction is intrastate or interstate. In this question, it is intrastate purchase. So here, the GST of 18% will be equally divided into CGST and SGST at 9% each. The next step is calculation of GST. It is calculated on 15,000 at 18%. That is 2,700. Thus, Raj has to pay a total tax of 2,700, which is divided into CGST 1350 and SGST 1350, and the total amount payable is 17,700. The journal entry for the above transaction will be purchases account debit 15,000, input CGST account debit 1350, input SGST account debit 1350. To creditors or cash bank account 17,700. Also, don't forget to write the narration. Now going to question number 2. Hiran is a dealer in Maharashtra, sold granite worth 26,000 to a GST registered dealer from outside his state on 8th October 2019. Now, this is interstate sales. So Hiran has to only charge IGST in his sales invoice, which will be on 26,000 at 18%, that equals to 4,680, and the total amount receivable is 30,680. The journal entry will be debtors of cash bank account debit 30,680 to sales account 26,000 to output IGST account 4,680. So friends, we hope that your answers were correct and you all have well understood these concepts of CGST, SGST or UTGST, IGST and input and output GST accounting. So now let's start with the today's session. We saw that input GST is debited with purchases and output GST is credited with sales. But in certain circumstances, input GST and output GST, that is CGST and SGST or IGST, may have to be reversed. The input GST is reversed in the following cases, that is when goods are returned to the seller, purchase return, goods taken by proprietor, goods given as free samples or as charity, goods lost by fire, accident, theft. Basically, your goods purchased are not sold but returned or lost or withdrawn by the owner. Similarly, output GST is reversed when the goods are returned by the customer, that is sales return. So, in reversal entry, input GST will be credited and output GST will be debited. Let's look at the journal entries for reversal of GST. First example, goods purchased were returned to the supplier. The entry would be, if it is the case of intrastate purchase return, then creditor's account debit to purchase return account to input CGST account to input SGST account. But if it is interstate purchase return, then the entry would be creditor's account debit to purchase return account to input IGST account. Second example, goods sold were returned by the customer and the entry would be, in case of intrastate sales return account debit, output CGST account debit, output SGST account debit to debtor's account. And if it is interstate sales return, then instead of CGST and SGST, we will debit output IGST account. We will understand more examples on this when we solve illustrations on journal entries with GST concept. Now moving ahead, let us study how we calculate GST payable. In previous session, we learned that while purchasing goods or receiving services, the seller charges the GST which we need to pay and it is accounted as input GST. And when goods or services are sold by us, we charge GST to our customers and accounted as output GST, right? But what is next after charging this GST? We will need to pay the tax collected to the government and for which we need to calculate GST payable. Let's take a very simple example to understand this. Say there is Mr. Dev who purchased the goods worth 10,000 and on that he paid GST at 18%. So here, his input GST at the time of purchases will be 1800. Now he added a profit of 2000 on his cost of 10,000 and sold the goods at a price of 12,000, where he collected GST at 18%, which amounted to 2160 and accounted as output GST. This amount which Mr. Dev collected has to be paid to the government. But how much will he pay? Will he pay 2160? No. At the time of purchases, he had already paid the tax of 1800. So now, he will deduct this 1800 of input GST from output GST of 2160 and net 360 would be the GST amount payable by him. The deduction of GST paid on purchases of goods, services or capital goods is called as input tax credit. So, every registered dealer is required to compute his tax liability after setting off the input GST. When input GST is deducted from output GST, the amount obtained is payable to the government and it is known as GST payable. Now, let's again solve a question on this which will help strengthen our concept. It is given that sales amount within the state is 1 lakh. Purchase amount within the state is 80,000. So, sales and purchases both are made within the state. GST rate is 18%. Find the GST payable. Here, both the sales and purchase transactions are within the state, that is intrastate. So, CGST and SGST will be applicable. The GST is calculated on intrastate sales of 1 lakh at 18% and the amount obtained is 18,000. Which is further divided into two equal parts, that is CGST 9000 and SGST 9000, correct? Similarly, for intrastate purchases of 80,000 at GST 18%, the amount of GST comes to 14,400, which is now divided into CGST 7200 and SGST 7200. This we know because this we have done many times till now. Now we are supposed to find the GST payable and the formula for it is output GST minus input GST. So from output CGST, deduct input CGST and similarly from output SGST, deduct input SGST which gives GST payable amount. So the net GST payable comes to 3600. Friends, in relation to set off, there are certain rules, limitations and restrictions on taking the input tax credit. But we are not discussing that in detail here. That is to be studied in detail while studying GST as an indirect tax subject as a whole. So now moving on to the last concept of today's session, that is reverse charge mechanism. Till now, we studied that normally the supplier of the goods and services pay the tax to the government on supply. But the reverse charge mechanism is the process of payment of GST by the receiver instead of supplier, that is the chargeability gets reversed. Now let's quickly overview some cases where the reverse charge is applicable. First, if the vendor is not registered under GST, supplies goods or services to the registered person, then reverse charge would apply. That is, the receiver has to pay GST to the government. For interstate purchase, from an unregistered dealer, buyer has to pay IGST, and for intrastate purchase, CGST and SGST have to be paid by the purchaser under reverse charge mechanism. The concept behind this is to prevent tax evasion, as it would be almost impossible to collect tax from the unregistered dealer. Second, if the e-commerce operator supplies services, then the reverse charge will be applicable to the e-commerce operator. He will be liable to pay the GST. Basically, e-commerce operator is the person who provides, manages, owns an electronic platform which is used to provide services. For example, Ola, Uber, cab services, urban cab services for plumbers, electricians, beauticians, etc. And RCM is applicable only if the services notified by the government are supplied through the electronic platform or operator. So here, electronic operator are liable to pay GST and collect it from the customers instead of the registered service providers. Third, also issued a list of goods and list of services on which reverse charge is applicable. Friends, again there are some important points to be taken care under reverse charge mechanism and various regulations we must follow as specified under the Act. Again, this would be studied in detail while studying GST in further levels of our studies. So that's all for today. Let's have a quick review of what we learned today. Firstly, we discussed about the cases where GST needs to be reversed. Then we learned about GST payable, set-off. And lastly, we understood the concept of reverse charge mechanism. So, in these four sessions till now on GST, we have got the basic idea as what is GST, various concepts and how it is accounted in the books. Currently, at this level, the main focus of us is on accounting of GST. But practically, when we want to file GST returns, doing GST audits, we need to study various rules and regulations of GST, which is to be studied in detail at higher levels. In next session, we will learn how journal entries with GST to be recorded for various transactions in the books of accounts. So stay tuned with us. Also, you can visit our website www.letstude.com, where you will find many courses at very affordable prices. So friends, see you all in the next session. Till then, keep watching, keep learning. Thank you.